This one, packing. Is the screen shared? When video plays, I will mute myself and I'll turn my camera off because otherwise it creates problems. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I'll mute myself, then only audio will be clear. But if it doesn't work properly, somebody can tell me. Who will tell?
Sir, can I?
Yes. Okay. Because I'll be mute. So if there is something, you can simply unmute yourself and speak from there.
Jerome K. Jerome, born in Staffordshire, is best known for his humorously narrated plays, novels, and essays. Following the death of his father, Jerome worked as a railway clerk, a school teacher, a journalist, and an actor. In 1885, he published his first book, On the Stage and Off, a comic memoir inspired by his acting career. His comic travelogue, Three Men in a Boat, catapulted him to literary stardom. His other known works include Three Men in a Bummel, Idle Thoughts of an Idle Fellow, and Paul Kelver. He also served as editor to the famous magazine The Idler, taking over from renowned novelist Rudyard Kipling. Jerome was known to have said that he had four ambitions of life: to write a successful play and a novel, to edit a successful journal, and to become a member of the parliament. The story Packing is an extract from his famous novel Three Men in a Boat. It describes the challenges that Jerome and his friends faced while packing for a holiday trip. Here is the summary of the story Packing by Jerome K. Jerome. Jerome, the narrator, was proud of his ability to pack anything. So he told his friends George and Harris to leave the packing up to him. To his surprise, they readily agreed to his suggestion. This was not what Jerome intended. His idea was to instruct George and Harris to do the work while he supervised them. He disliked it when people sat idly and did nothing while he did all the work. Jerome was irritated, but he decided to start packing. It took him longer than anticipated, but he finally managed to pack everything. However, just when he was closing the last bag, Harris asked him if he had packed in the boots. Jerome was annoyed. He thought it was just like Harris to remind him of the boots when he was almost finished with packing. Of course, he had to open the bag and pack the boots inside it. It was then that he remembered his toothbrush. His toothbrush gave him trouble every time he traveled somewhere. He would pack it the night before and unpack it in the morning to use it. Then he would forget to repack it and would have to rush at the last moment to get his toothbrush and run to the station. He unpacked his bag again, but he could not find the toothbrush. He had to reopen everything again to find it. Finally, he found it inside a boot. Poor Jerome had to repack everything once again. By this time, Jerome was exhausted. He gave in to Harris's suggestion to let him and George do the packing. George and Harris took over from Jerome. But Jerome did not think they would do any better than him. He believed that George and Harris were the worst packers in the entire world. Jerome was right. Almost immediately, they broke a cup. Then Harris packed strawberry jam on top of a tomato. The jam squashed the tomato, and they had to scoop the tomato out with a spoon. Jerome said nothing, but came over to watch. This made George and Harris even more nervous. They were so nervous that they packed the pies at the bottom and the heavy things on top. The pies were completely smashed. Then they started packing the butter. Jerome had never seen anyone treat a stick of butter the way George and Harris did in his entire life. George stepped onto the butter. He and Harris had to scrape it out of his slipper. Then they tried to put it in a kettle, but that did not work. So they had to scoop out all the butter from the kettle and put it on the chair. Harris then sat on the butter. Now it was stuck to him. George and Harris, not knowing this, looked for the butter everywhere. Finally, George found it sticking to Harris. He managed to get it off Harris and put it in the teapot. Their packing became more complicated with the addition of Montmorency. Montmorency was Jerome's dog, and it was his ambition in life to get in everyone's way. If he went a day without things being thrown at him, he felt day wasted. Now, he came and sat on the things to be packed. He put his leg into the jam, upset the teaspoons, and pretended that the lemons were rats. He squashed three of the lemons before Harris chased him away with a frying pan. Finally, the packing was done at 12:50 a.m. The three of them decided to go to bed. George asked them at what time should they wake up. Harris said 7 and Jerome said 6. This led to a debate between the two. In the spirit of compromise, they finally settled on waking up at 6:30. They turned to ask George for his opinion, but he had fallen asleep during the debate. Jerome and Harris placed a bathtub next to him. This way, when he woke up in the morning, he would tumble into it. Finally, Jerome and Harris went to bed as well.
Enjoyed the story?
Yes, sir.
To enjoy, we need to understand it first. So I should have asked, understood the story?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the part of the story, the longer one, Three Men in a Boat, that we read here or that we watched today and that you have in your syllabus, is just an extract, it's just a part of that. And all that took place at a particular time. So this incident, which Jerome has described in this lesson, how long does it take to complete all that has happened here? At what time did it start? At what time this part of the story gets over? Can somebody tell? Anyone? When do you think it has started? Speak.
Start packing done at 12:50.
Packing got over at 12:50. And at what time do you think it would have started?
Sir, 10:05.
Is it given or it's a guess?
Sir, guess.
Yes, very, very accurate kind of guess. 10:05. Why did you say 10:05?
Sir, packing at least take 2 hours or 3 hours.
Okay. So your idea is because they had to pack some 3 bags, they were 3 in number. So it would have taken some 2-3 hours time. So the packing would have started at around 10 p.m. You may be right, maybe 9:10, because next morning they were to travel, and during that daytime they would have finished other works, whichever work they were engaged in, and then at night they would have started packing, and this took some 2-3 hours to finish packing. Was packing a fun for them?
Yes, sir.
How many of you think that it was fun for them? Those who think it was fun can write in the chat section F. And those who think it was not a fun for them, rather it was a trouble for them, you can write T. I want 21 responses. Turn your caps lock on when you write. Nilay, how many T's and how many F's? How many T's and how many F's are there?
Sir, there is only one F by Nakul and 5, 6, 7 and sir 9, 10. Sir, 15 T's.
But we are 20 numbers. Okay. So most of you think it was a trouble, and just one or two students think it was a fun. Now, instead of saying that it was fun for them, is it right to say it was fun for readers?
Yes, sir.
If I say it wasn't fun for those who were packing, Jerome and the other two, George and Harris. What were the names? Jerome, George and Harris. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it wasn't fun for them. It was a challenge for them. It was a difficult thing that they were doing, they did. And for us who read the story or to watch, it was a fun. We enjoyed. Okay. Now I want some students, or if not some, everybody can also do one thing. Just to mention one thing that you remember that has happened in the story. Just one thing. Sooner you start mentioning, more chances you get, more options do you have to speak about, and later you speak, you will have lesser options left.
Sir, but you are speaking to Harris.
Huh?
Sir, but you are speaking to Harris.
Who is speaking to Harris?
Sir, but sir, when he sat on the chair.
Speaking. Yes, yes, yes. Will it be better if you start speaking in? Not exact order, but at least what happened first, first thing first, that way. Because sticking of butter took place almost at the last, at the end of the story. What you told is correct, but what I'm asking you to start with is first thing first. And it's open for everybody. Tomato squashed because he kept a bottle of jam on tomato, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And it happened when George and Harris, they started packing. This means you did not mention anything that happened while Jerome K. Jerome was packing. So it is again after half of the story. Statement is correct.
Both.
What do you mean? Yes. Once he finished packing, one friend comes and reminds him about boots, and then he had to unpack whole bag once again and put the boots once again.
Sir, Jerome forgot to take his toothbrush, but he packed it.
To keep it.
He thought.
Yes.
Yes, sir, he thought.
Okay. When he was talking about toothbrush, he told about one of his habits about toothbrush. What was that?
Sir, that he packs the toothbrush in night and when he take out in the morning to brush his teeth, he always forgot to pack it back.
Very nice. At night he packs, and in morning, when he gets up and he needs to brush, he finds he has to look for his toothbrush once again, which is in the bag. Then he takes it out, brushes, and in a rush, he forgets to pack it again.
Sir, when the dog enters?
Dog entered at last once again. Dog Montmorency, what was the name? Montmorency?
Yes, sir.
It came at last. Who chased the dog?
Sir, Harry.
Harry with the frying pan.
With the frying pan. Okay. Now, anything else that you remember? How was Jerome feeling when first he wanted to boss the activity, and then two of his friends, they sat idly in the sofa and they simply watched Jerome packing? How was he feeling at that moment?
Sir, he was irritated.
He was irritated. And with their suggestions or questions or reminding him about something doing after the packing was almost over, annoyed him also. He got angry. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, because Jerome was a good packer, or he believes that he was skilled in packing, he took up the task of packing. What happened? What was the cause that last bag was packed by George and Harris? Why did Jerome stop packing? What happened? Say something, bhai.
Sir, because he was exhausted.
He was exhausted. He was doing it all alone, and he did it for a long time. He packed two bags. So he was tired, completely exhausted, and was in not a condition to do it anymore. And so he decided to stop, and then the other friends started doing it. What did Jerome think about his friends, about their skills of packing?
Sir, they were not that good in packing.
I couldn't get it. What did you say?
Sir, he thinks that
one. He was
Sir, he thinks that.
Just a minute. Two students are speaking together. First, the boy who started speaking, let him finish, and then I'll come to the girl. Which boy was speaking? Was it Nakul?
Yes, sir.
Haan, bolo.
Sir, he thinks that they were not good in packing.
Just that? Okay.
Sir, he thought that they were the worst packers in the world.
He considered them the worst packers in the entire world. That was the statement. Was he right when he thought so about them?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
They proved that he was right when they started packing, when they started keeping heavy things on the softer, tender, delicate things. Then the case of butter. The whole story is funny, but one more very funny thing, that when the butter was kept on a chair, one of them sits on it, and when it was stuck to him, they did not even know. They were looking for that butter everywhere. So it shows that how foolish they were in this job, in this task. But do you think packing, task of packing, is really challenging for anybody? There is no technique involved, there is no technology needed, there is no skill needed. But because there are so many things and nothing is classified, you have to carry so many things. You get all of those things right in front of you, all together, and then you need to arrange them in your baggages. So it becomes a big challenge to manage them all and to keep everything without forgetting anything. Do you agree that packing is a challenge for everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. One person said, yes, sir, nobody else. Those who think packing is a challenge can write C. And those who think it's not a challenge can write NC. Shubham Sahu says it's not a challenge. Good. Ujit also says not a challenge. Ujit, do you pack for yourself or your parents, your mother packs for you?
Sir, I pack for myself.
You do yourself. Good. Most said C. It's a challenge. Good. Now, shall I assign you a task to check your packing skills or arranging skills? May I assign you a task? Say yes or no.
Yes.
A very, very interesting task. Very interesting task. You will enjoy it. Shall I give you this challenge? Dare. Achha, how many of you are ready to take the challenge that I am going to give? Right eye. I'll give those who write eye, not everyone. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Only 8 out of 20. Only 8 students have written I. That's not very encouraging. Achha, those who don't want to do it can write N now. And everybody else has to write N because those who wanted to do have written I already. Sajid suddenly thought of writing I. Good. Sajid has changed his mind. Okay. I was not going to give you a big assignment or a big challenge. It's a simple, small thing. I'm giving you a time till the next class. Those who wrote IE, 9 students. It's not compulsory for everybody. If everybody did it, it was a good thing. So for those who want to do it, you have 2 things at home that you come across every day and that you use every day. What are those 2 things?
Television and mobile.
Fine. It's an honest answer, it's a true answer. Something else that you come across every day or that you use every day.
Toothbrush?
Huh? What did you say? Right here in the chat box. I'm not getting it.
Sir, Sir, he is saying toothbrush.
Toothbrush. He uses his toothbrush every day twice. Yes, fine. Or what else?
The TV remote.
Get away from TV and remote and mobile phone and computer. Get away from
books.
Books. Okay. Yes.
Sir, copy.
Using of mind, someone says, if you have pen, somebody says.
Sir, family.
Somebody said clothes. Someone said family. Good. Or more ideas? Copies. Copies means notebooks, you want to say. Water. Okay. Food, watch. Very interesting. Very interesting. Comb, whatever. How many times in a day? If it was written by a boy, then 50, 60 times in a day. And if it was written by a girl, hardly two times or one day. What was the last statement? I didn't get it. See the face in mirror. Rajwardhan Singh is writing that. Okay. How many times do you go to and do you touch and do you use your study table in a day?
Sir, 4-5.
Where are you sitting right now?
The bedroom.
Sir, study room.
Aren't you at your study table? When you attend classes,
yes,
you attend classes, it's a suggestion, it's a good thing that you sit at your table in a proper posture. If you keep yourself straight, more than 15 times somebody is saying. Don't attend the class sitting in your bedroom, or even if you are in bedroom, no problem if you are using a table over there. Chair and table, but stay away from bed. That's not good. Chalo, so you do you agree that you come across your study table many a times in a day?
Sir, please repeat.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, second thing, what about your cupboard? Cupboard. Yes or no? How many times do you use it?
Yes,
how many times do you go in front of your cupboard, you open it and you close it, you take things out of it, you keep things inside? Does it happen?
Sir, two times.
Many times it happens in a day?
Yes, sir.
Good. So, do you agree that the two things that I mentioned, one is your cupboard and the another thing is your study table, these are the two things that you use and manage many a times in a day, every day? Yes?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now, the third thing is your bed. When you wake up, you leave everything as it is, or probably you arrange them. Then you study in your bed. You leave your books and everything over there, your pen lying here, pencil lying there, or probably you arrange. So you keep or manage your bed also. But I'm not coming to bed. I'm talking about first two things, that is table and your desk where you study and your cupboard. How many of you are in a position to show, turn your camera on and show the condition of your table right now? How many of you are in such a position? Or do you think that your study table is arranged nicely that it can be shown? And if not, the only reason is that it is very, very badly mismanaged. Piles of books must be lying. Some useless things must be there. There would be a mess. And there would be a mess in your cupboard also. Okay? So the task is for these 9 children. And if somebody else also feels like doing it. First thing you will do today is you will arrange your table properly with all your used or useful books and notebooks kept piled up properly. Desk cleaned, drawer arranged, drawer of your table arranged. That you can take a nice picture, nice photograph of your table. Arrange it in such a way. This is one thing for today. And for tomorrow, arrange your cupboard properly. Arrange your cupboard properly. I don't want a photograph of your cupboard. No interest. And it's not a thing that can be shared. You can simply write that I have arranged my cupboard. And whenever I get an opportunity of talking to our parents, I will ask them. So I'll get the proof. I'll ask them. Okay, whether you have arranged your cupboard really or not. I'll cross-check it with your parents whenever I get a chance to talk to them. And your table, I want a photograph of properly arranged table today. Can it be done? Let me see how good you are at packing and arranging things.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So there are only 9 students who took this task, and there are many who refused to do it, to do this. So those who have refused, fine, no problem. But those who have taken, they will arrange their tables today and they will arrange their cupboards tomorrow. No need of sharing any photograph. I'll ask your parents if you are really arranging your cupboard and tables every day or not. Okay? Just to develop a good habit, because we are talking about this story which has something to do with packing, so I just asked you to do this today. But it's a habit that has to be developed. Now, lesson is clear to everyone, I hope. Discussion is done.
Yes, sir.
I have asked some questions, yes, and you were actually giving good answers. You've answered all my questions, so you understood the story, it seems. And there are very simple, ordinary things that happened, that took place, and the story got over. Just one thing we did not discuss after watching the video was what happened at last. What did they do at last? First thing, before going to bed, there was an argument about the time of getting up, and they finally decided to get up at
6:30.
Yes, yes, go ahead. At 6:30, they decided to get up, and one of those 3 friends was already asleep. Before they could decide, before they could come to some decision or conclusion. One was already slept. So what did they do for him?
Sir, they kept nearby the water, full of water tub.
Water tub. Why did they do that?
Sir, when he wake up, he go into the
water. He will tumble into the tub. So was it a mischief then?
Yes, sir.
So it was kind of prank they were trying to play on him, because he slept first. When some 2-3 friends, they stay together, whoever sleeps first, definitely some mischief or some prank is done on him. It happens. And it happens in friendship. So it was just a light, mild, ordinary prank being played. And this is where the story ends. The story gets over. Now, if you have any question, if you want to ask anything out of this lesson, you may ask now. You still have 3 minutes before we finish up with the class. Any question from the lesson or from anywhere else? No questions?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, very soon, we are going to have a class test. Yeah. Very soon means within few days. I'll prepare a set of questions. I'll post it here. You'll have to answer and respond. Okay. So be prepared with everything that we have already done. Go through all the lessons once again. And after we finish with this lesson, we shall try to start some topics of grammar. Just remind me when this lesson. It's already over. It's already over. So probably from the next class, you can remind me of starting with the grammar part. Okay? We'll try to do how much can be done in the class online. So because no more questions, it is 3:09. So shall I stop now?
Yes, sir.
3 comments more than 15 times. Achha, theek hai. That was about my question. Chalo. That means now you can say Sairam and leave the class. I'm also stopping to record.
Sairam, sir.
Sairam, sir.
Sairam, sir.
Sairam, sir.
Sairam, sir.